comes this all this complex thought, in fact, our inability to understand this culture, it is just we are just always thinking in functionalist approach. The first comes adaptation. When we ask why we have eyes, people generally answer, we have eyes to see. But no, we don't have any eyes to see. We have eyes because our genes are programmed to produce eyes. Why genes who produce eyes have been fixed in the society is that because they give us ability to see and they make us survive. But it is not the reason why we have eyes. We have eyes because we have genes who produce eyes. So characteristics do not come to existence because they make this or that being more able to survive. They come to existence by chance, and if they do cause, they do not cause the being having those characteristics to extinct, then they get the chance to get to be fixed in the population. For the first time, when language appears, it is based on evidences, solid evidences that we have. It is in Sumer, and the oldest given date, it is 3200 BC. It is the first solid evidence that we have from the beginning of language. So I suggest that if language exists, it exists not much before that, before 3200 BC. Before that, I don't say people didn't say any word. They communicated, but they couldn't, I think, they couldn't tell any stories. So if we define language, the capability to tell stories, for me it seems that it is around this date, not before that. So language produces analog eye. Analog eye, in the process of evolution, we have abstract thought came in Greek world, and the idea of an abstract soul and God. In fact, for me, religion, if we want to find out where and how religion has been produced, we should search the house of Socrates, not the house of prophets. Prophets were just, for me, they are just one part of their society. The people who have made the abstract idea of God and soul, they're Greeks, Greek philosophy. After that, it comes final consciousness. So it is the pattern of conscious robo-homo. You just merge them. As you see, there is some part outside of everything. It is decision-making processor. This is our unconscious part, I think. This language processor, it has some access to decision-making, some access to...